Hey team, Andre from High Performance Academy here. Welcome along to another one of our webinars.
And I just want to cover a couple of new products from HP Tuners as well, or relatively new products. We'll just go to our overhead, and this is their MPVI 3 interface. So wasn't that long ago that they actually updated to the MPVI 2. That gave them the ability to work with some vehicles that previously they couldn't work with on the MPVI 1. Some other advantages with the MPVI 2 and of course the MPVI 3 is that it does have a Bluetooth connection to your laptop. Nice thing with the MPVI 3 is it includes the what HP Tuners call their Pro feature set as standard. It's not an upgrade like it was with the MPVI 2. This means that it has standalone onboard data logging, which is really nice if you don't want to have your laptop in the car at all times, particularly on a racetrack. It's not super practical to have a laptop floating around in the car. So this will actually log directly onto the MPVI 3 interface in comparison to the previous MPVI 2, where that was an optional upgrade. It is included as standard, as I mentioned, and it is also now offering double the logging memory. It's gone from 4 gigabytes to 8, so should be plenty for most applications. It's also at a faster logging rate. The other feature with that Pro feature set is if you want to add this little adapter harness here, the Prolink, this is a Prolink Plus, you can then wire in additional sensors. So you can wire in 2 additional analog sensors or 1 or plus 1 CAN sensor. So if you want to bring in maybe a wideband or maybe an individual separate map sensor, or basically whatever you may want to add, you can bring those straight into the interface via the Prolink Plus adapter. Lastly as well, and this is relevant to some material we are going to be releasing sometime this year, is this little adapter. I'll get this under the overhead. So this is an OBD2 to BRP adapter. So BRP is CanAm, CDU, so Powersports, which HP Tuners have started supporting as well. So this is the little adapter here. It goes onto the vehicle side interface and then basically turns it into a conventional OBD2 connector. These Powersports vehicles don't generally have a traditional standard rectangular style OBD2 port, so you'll need that if you want to tune those. The reason I mention that is we do have a CanAm side-by-side. That side-by-side UTV, ATV market is getting quite large, and we wanted to be able to provide some information around that. So that will be coming out. I can't say at this point exactly when that will be. Later this year is about all I can actually mention. We are about to release a new worked example for our practical Reflash tuning course. For those who don't know what that course is, it is a course that teaches you the fundamentals and a practical step-by-step process that you can apply to reflashing factory-based ECUs. Now, the course itself is generic, so it really doesn't matter if you're using HP Tuners, EFI Live, ECU Flash, ROM Raider, Cobb, or just about anything else. The actual principles behind the tuning are really more related to the way the factory ECU operates compared to how the software and hardware interface you're using for the tuning actually works. So really, it doesn't matter what you learn on, you'll be able to apply that. So the course teaches you all of those principles, and then it provides a nice, simple, straightforward 6-step process that you can apply to tuning your own vehicle. So again, this is a generic process. Doesn't matter if you're tuning a Corvette or maybe a Honda Civic. It doesn't matter. The process is exactly the same. And this makes sure that you don't overlook any critical steps that could waste time, waste money, or potentially damage your engine. However, from there we move into a library of worked examples, and that worked example library is an informal walkthrough of the 6-step process, and you can then see it being applied on a range of different vehicles or engines using a variety of different tuning platforms. Now, the reason I cover all of this is because if we jump across to my laptop screen, we are going to be releasing a Gen 5 LT4 GM worked example using this Cadillac CTS-V that is on the screen in front of me. Sam was over in the US back in December and shot this with one of our good friends who operates innovative tuning over there, Mike McGuinness. So he's fronting this worked example, and there are some fundamental differences with the Gen 5 GM engines, particularly they are direct injected, and they also use a torque-based model. So we have been asked for this information for some time. This is going to be perfect for anyone who wants to branch out into the Gen 5 platform, which obviously, of course, is no longer a new platform, and it is about time we did bring this out. If you are interested in learning more about the course, you can check that out at hpacademy.com/courses, and you're looking for practical reflash tuning. Now, with all of those courses, we do add to this library of worked examples from time to time. This goes for our standalone tuning course as well as our engine building course. And once you own the course, it's yours for life. You get any future worked examples at no additional cost. So pretty excited to be launching that. While I am talking about this vehicle, it was tuned on the HP Tuners platform. And again, as I mentioned, it doesn't really matter what platform you're making your tuning changes on. The tables that you've got access to and the way you manipulate them are really related to what is inside the factory engine controller anyway. So it doesn't really matter, but we are using HP Tuners for this, which is a popular platform. If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.